y'all, and welcome to today's video. We are going to be judging new makeup. Every Sunday, we sit down together, we look at all the new makeup releases, things that are coming soon. Maybe they haven't launched yet, but we have sneak peeks, things that have been released. We're going to judge them. We're never gonna judge each other. We're gonna be nice, we're gonna be respectful. The world would be a boring place if we all looked the same, sounded the same, liked the same things. If I hate something and you love it, then guess what? I love it for you. I just wanna judge the makeup, the products. We're gonna say, is it cute, is it ugly? Do we want it, do we not want it? Are we gonna buy it? Is it something we want, but we're not gonna buy it? You know, we're just gonna share. I'm gonna pop up photos of all the new releases. I'm gonna have so much fun sharing my opinions with y'all because I think there's some pretty interesting stuff releasing this week. So, with all that being said, let's jump into it. Okay, let's start off by talking about this new Pat McGrath Mini Eyeshadow Palette in Sublime Smoke. So, this little palette is coming to Sephora on April 10th, and it's going to be $29. Now, I know this is very neutral and simple, but I'm planning to pick this one up, and I do plan to review it for y'all, let y'all know if it's any good, what I think of it, because I do think that's a really good price point. Six shades for $29 from Pat McGrath, I think is really nice. She does have one palette like this. It's in purple packaging. I have a video on that one if you want to check it out, but I thought the quality in there was really nice. It was kind of half purpley tones and half neutral shades. So I was excited to see her do another palette like this, but one that's completely like warm neutrals. I think that's really smart. And I think even if it wasn't for me, I still think this is a smart release. Now, I love Pat McGrath, so I want to buy it. I want to try it for myself. I will definitely let you know how it is if you were curious about this one. But this says this is a limited edition mini mirrored eyeshadow palette with 6 warm neutrals. So this palette has, let's look at the top row. I like that we have a very light, almost like warm vanilla type of shimmer. We have a mid-tone kind of caramel brown shade, and then it looks like we have a more champagne, lighter gold type of shade. On the bottom row, there is a really warm tone, what looks to be a mid-tone matte, and then a deep dark brown matte, and then it looks like we have a more intense gold style shimmer there. So like I said, I want to test this out. I want to know if it's the same quality that was in her other little mini palette. I think this is cute. Is it anything revolutionary? No, but I feel like this is for a specific customer. These palettes too, like they're tiny. Like it's around the size of this Sigma blush. Like it's a very, very small palette, which I think is perfect for like keeping your makeup collection small and managed too. If you want to put all your makeup in a bag or a bathroom drawer, something like that, this is not going to take up a lot of space. So I'm excited. I'm going to test it. I'm going to see if the quality is there, and I will definitely let you know. Okay, Byredo has revealed their new eyeshadow palette. So this palette is the Remembrance palette, and it is going to be limited edition. 18 pan palette with neutrals, warm and cool tones, silver chrome packaging. Right now, all I know is that it's coming soon and that it's not for me. So, with the Pat McGrath, it was very neutral, warm tones, but it was also very curated, in my opinion. I feel like I could see a couple of different looks with that palette, and it was only 6 shades and compact. Whereas this palette is a bit larger, and it's kind of peachy pink leaning neutrals. So if I'm looking at this shade on the top row, if I'm looking at this palette, sorry if I'm misspeaking. Let me drink my Dr. Pepper. But if I'm looking at the top row of this palette, the 2 shades at the end of the row kind of look similar. I would have to see more swatches, because even like everything Byredo has posted, those shades look the same. And then if I look at the second shade on the top row, the second shade on the second row, those two shades look to have a very same tone, very similar finish. Now, I think there is value in having shades that are very similar in different depths. You know, a dark brown, a mid-tone brown, a light brown. I find value as that. I'm somebody that loves eyeshadow. I love blending. I love mixing shades. I love pulling in multiple shades. So I don't mind large palettes that have ranges of different tones in the color, but I don't like when they look exactly the same, and that's just what I'm getting from this palette. And in this palette of 18 shades, there are only two shades that are deep and dark. So I don't know, for me this is an easy pass. I also know that Byredo is a pricey brand, it's a luxury brand, so I would have been open to this palette if maybe I had that quad down in the bottom corner with the dark brown, the more orangey peachy shade, the lighter pinky brown, that bronze, or even if it was a six pan with the two columns on the end, I could have been open to that. But overall, just looking at this, I don't think it's a palette I'll get a lot of use out of. I don't have a price yet, but I know these palettes from Byredo are usually around $100. So I think I'll keep my money, but let me know if you're into it. Okay, I'm gonna pop up the reel or the short, the YouTube short that I made on these new Sigma Cream blushes. I have not seen official photos of these yet. If I find one, I'll put that up instead. But if not, you can see my reel. Sigma sent me these cream blushes. Now, I did upload this video as a YouTube short. If you haven't seen that yet, definitely watch my shorts. I try to post tutorials and stuff there too, just like quicker videos. But these are launching on April 11th. My affiliate code with Sigma is HeatherAustin10. If you're ever on the Sigma site, you want to use a code. You don't have to use mine, but it's there if you'd like to. Now, these shades, there are four different shades, and these are really, really pretty. I have worn every shade on the face now. I'm wearing one shade today. I'm wearing this shade right here. This is Nearly Wild. I'm not sure. This may be my favorite. I actually put this on when my face was already set, like had foundation and concealer on, but no powder. So I put it on with a brush. I don't know where I set the brush, but I have loved applying these with a brush. I've also used my finger. I've also used it on top of powder. But today I wanted a blush that was really sunk into the skin. I didn't want to put it on top of powder. I wanted a little less drama from my blush. So I put it on top of my cream products and then I set my face with powder, but I didn't go on top with any powder blush. And this is what that shade looks like. The formula is very pretty. I really like these compacts. So I'll show you again really quick. Here is Nearly Wild. And then I have this one right here is Coral Dawn. And then I have Pashmina. If you want to see these blushes on the face, I am wearing them in my last Bella Beauty Bar video. So you can definitely check that out to see them on. And then their iconic shade in Cordurosa, they also made in cream form. So I'm really liking that formula. Of course, I'm going to test and try them more, and I will follow up in a speed review later on after I've worn them a few more times. But I have been wearing these this week and really liking them. Kylie Cosmetics is launching some new products. I'm not interested in these, but we are going to talk about them because I think maybe some of y'all will be interested. These are matte liquid eyeshadows. This is a cream to powder formula with up to 12 hours of crease proof wear in 5 different shades. So the shades that I'm seeing are very nude neutral shadows, nothing like super intense, which I think can be really nice. I am very picky when it comes to liquid eyeshadow formulas. I have deep set eyes and I have oily skin. So I have so many like creases and folds in my eyes, and a bad liquid shadow will settle and crack. Like the Colourpop liquid shadows from the Cora collection, terrible. Like, the more I wore them, the worse they got. I'm very picky with liquid shadows. Ones I love are from Half Magic Beauty, NYX. They're eye paints. I love those. I love Melt gel liners as liquid shadows. I love Lethal's gel liners as liquid shadows. Like, I'm picky. So for that reason, and because none of these look like shades that I really need, maybe the deep dark one, but overall, I'm just going to pass on these. Kylie is also coming out with a mascara. So these are going to be available at Ulta on April 6th. I will link them down below. Everything I talk about, if I can find links to it, I will put it down below. If I have a release date, anything like that, it'll be in the description box. All the Instagram accounts that I look at for makeup news are in the description box, so definitely check there. But overall, this Kylie launch is a pass. Okay, Ole Henriksen. We have this sneak peek of this Dewtopia Flash Mask. Now, I don't know how this, like, came about so early. I saw this from Trend Mood because it says it's going to be available August 18th. We're at the beginning of April, so we have a long time to wait, but I'm just gonna let you know I'm gonna buy this. I am going to buy this. This says 10% AHAs, 15% PHAs, and Scandinavian rowan berry oil. So this claims it transforms skin from dull to radiant in 5 to 10 minutes. Smooth texture and fine lines and wrinkles, brighten and even skin tone. It has a sheer iridescent color derived from natural cocoons and envelops the skin wall, allowing the high potency acids to work. Lemon sugar is the naturally derived fragrance in this. There's salicylic acid to clarify and control surface oil. I like salicylic acid, hyaluronic acid to bind moisture and plump the skin, 20% aloe juice to condition and calm the skin. So everything about this intrigues me. I have oily skin. I'm 35. I live in a very humid place. I am prone to breakouts, even though I'm 35. So hearing that this has salicylic acid, AHA, PHAs, and moisturizing, hydrating ingredients, all of that sounds like something I'm gonna love. I'll definitely keep y'all updated. If I see that this is launching sooner than August, I will let y'all know. I hope so, because, like, I want this. I really want this mask. I think it looks super cool. Let me know. Are you interested in this skincare release? Okay, let's talk about this release from Melt Cosmetics. We did not get a 420 release from Melt last year, so I am very happy to see that they are having their Electrip collection. Finally, another release for 420. Every time I talk about Melt's makeup that is cannabis inspired, people are like, oh no, but listen. It's a plant, okay? We're not gonna focus on that. We're gonna focus on the makeup. Don't be offended, it's cool. This collection, I believe, is launching April 2nd? I'm not sure, I can't remember. I will put it in the description box. I don't see it right here in front of me. But what I am planning to purchase from this collection is the eyeshadow palette. So let's talk about this first. The Electrip eyeshadow palette. This says, this 420, we take you on a trip. Welcome to our bright, lucid dream. Immerse yourself in the psychedelic colors of the new Electrip palette. Creamy chromes and true vivid mattes. So, I like that half of this palette is very warm and half of this is more cool. It reminds me a lot of their Vita palette that they did for Los Dias de la Muerte a few years ago. But it looks like it's more... I don't want to say more amped up, but it looks like it's just a little different. You know, the reds and the oranges look to be a little more on the orangey leaning side. Then it looks like we have a very warm leaning brown. And then the blues and the greens look a little more blue leaning or more like cobalt leaning, I should say. That's what I get from this. I think the packaging looks really, really cool. I like that a lot. I like that it's in their typical, you know, kind of Melt packaging. And really, really pretty. Oh, I see. I'm sorry. This is not launching April 2nd. This is launching April 4th at 12 p.m. Pacific. So I will put that down in the description box. Also, with this collection, they're launching 3 new lip paints. So these say that they are hypnotizing liquid lips that are shimmery, they set to a foil, and then they stain for long-lasting effect. So Muse is an emerald green with a green stain, Sunburst is a sunset golden orange with an orange stain, and Free Love is a violet blue with a blue stain. Now, I am not planning to pick up these lip paints. I know myself, I'm not going to get enough use out of this. I do have some fun lip colors. The one I gravitate toward most when I'm talking about bold lips is either like a purple, a green, or a black. So I don't really want these in this metallic finish. If I want something like that, I'll usually just use a liquid lip and then go over top with a sparkly gloss. So those are a no for me. And we also have the Kaleidoscope Body Glitter. So this says it's holographic opal with warm glitter. And I wanted to check because if you've been on my channel for a while, you know that I love my Melt glitters that came out in their last 420 collection, or maybe it wasn't their last one, maybe it was the one before that, but these were called Glitter Pots, and this is called Body Glitter. So I'm not sure if I'm going to buy that. If it's the same formula as the Glitter Pots, I definitely will because I love that formula. I think it's so nice. So this one I'm kind of on the fence about. I have a few days to think about it, maybe see some more videos or swatches from Melt. But holographic opal with warm glitter sounds beautifully. Multi-dimensional body glitter that applies like a dream, adheres to the skin, no fallout. It says the more you layer this gel, the more surreal it gets. Transfer proof, multi-size glitter for the most illumination and not for use around the eye area. Of course not with these larger glitter particles. So I don't know. I think I may buy it, but I'm just on the fence. I'm definitely not planning to buy the lip paints or the bag, but the eyeshadow palette 100% and the glitter I'm kind of half and half undecided on right now because it does look super pretty, but I'm most excited for the eyeshadow palette. I love Melt shadows. I have an entire Melt playlist if you want to check out my reviews and videos on some of their other stuff. I just think they make some really cool products and they've kind of like slacked off a little bit over the past few years. Melt Cosmetics is an indie brand, so even though they're big, they're sold at Sephora and Camera Ready and different places, they are still independently owned. Remember, indie brand does not mean small brand. It means that it is independently owned. It is not owned by a large corporation, an umbrella company, a parent company, whatever you want to call it. It is independently owned, and I love that. I love supporting independently owned businesses. So that's another reason why I love Melt, but the lipsticks, definitely a pass. Unearthly Cosmetics has launched a new liquid eyeliner. I have never tried this one, but listen, one thing about me is I love Unearthly Cosmetics, so I'm definitely going to add this next time I place an order. I actually just placed an order at the middle of March and ordered a bunch of their lashes because I had run out. So next time I place an order, maybe when I pick up the rest of the lip glosses, I'm going to add this to my cart too because this looks pretty and it looks like the type of liquid liner I really like. So that's definitely on my list of things to try. Okay, let's talk about Blend Bunny. I love Blend Bunny. I think they make amazing products, such a cool, fun brand. And they have said that they are going to release 5 new products or 5 different parts to their new launch. I only have part of it. What you're seeing here, let's talk about it. So there are lip oils. Lip oils. I love a good lip oil, so I am over the moon excited for this. I'm actually wearing Blend Bunny lip today. I'm wearing Doll Face liquid lipstick and lip liner, not Blend Bunny. I'm wearing Lavender Sorbet from Lawless, their lip gloss. But I love a lip oil and I want these from Blend Bunny, and I know they make good lip liner, good lipstick. So I want to try these lip oils 100%. I do have an affiliate code with Blend Bunny. It's Heather. If you want to use it, it will save you money at checkout. Definitely don't have to, but it's there. All of my codes, everything link in the description box. So this is going to be a launch on April 7th, so on Friday at 12 p.m. Central. So here's what we have so far. We have the lip oils. That is maybe what I'm most excited for. However many colors they're gonna have, I'm gonna have to buy them all. I have orange, purple, and like a pinky red in this photo. I'm not sure if that's all of them, if there's gonna be more. I need all three though, I know that. And then there is going to be a blush palette. This is called Juicy Cheeks Face Palette. So I love a good colorful blush. I think they're so fun, purples and pinks and orangey shades and more yellowy orange shades. I think this looks so fun. I really like my Blend Bunny highlighter palette. I like their lip products. I like their brushes. I like their eyeshadow palettes. So far, everything I've tried from the brand, I really like. There's also gonna be a blush. So this says it is a blush colored brush to go perfectly with either side of the launch. So you can see in this image, the Blend Bunny logo, there's one in a colorful orangey pink side and one in a more pinky nude side. So the brush, they say, goes perfectly with both sides of the launch. And it says they want the bounce into the blush pan, bouncing motions onto the cheek. So not swiping, just bouncing. I want to try this. I think this looks really cool. And I know Blend Bunny just showed the outside packaging. I'll pop that photo up now of their Bare Cheeks face palette. So I think if you're not into that super colorful blush palette like I am, maybe keep your eye out for this one. The blush palettes or the face palettes are going to be $32, also launching on April 7th. And I will put it all in the description box. I need both of these. I love colorful blushes. I love more nude blushes. So whatever it is, your girl needs it. Trust, you'll be seeing a review on my channel. Glaminatrix has shown fully their Into the Night palette. So I'm popping up this collage. This is beautiful. I really like Glaminatrix. I think their palettes are so nice. The first palette that I ever bought from the brand was their You Beauty palette. And it kind of started my love. I'm like, oh wow. Okay, this Australian brand, they're out here doing something. It was totally worth the shipping and the weight and all of that. I really love that palette. And they've put out a lot of great ones that I've tried since then. So this is the Into the Night palette. I think the packaging looks cool and sleek and luxe. And then I love inside that we have some kind of pinky, maybe like raspberry type tones, greens, blues, that shade. All I can see at the bottom is it's called The Rocks. That looks pretty. Is that like a black purpley shimmer? I don't know. Whatever it is, it's beautiful. Okay, Colourpop has released new shadow sticks. I was super shocked that Colourpop sent me these. I cannot wait to play with them. I think I'm going to include them in an upcoming Get Ready With Me, maybe some YouTube shorts, something like that. But these are Shadow Sticks Effortless Cream Eyeshadow Stick. I really think a lot of people love shadow sticks. I tend to use them more for like bases or for the inner corner, but usually as a base for shadows. So I can't wait to play with these. They're available on the Colourpop website now, and they're also available at Target and at Ulta. So I will link them down below. Shadow sticks can be such an easy way to do an effortless look. You just kind of put it on and you can blend with a brush, or you can kind of pat in with your finger, get a wash of color all over the lid. I'm intrigued to see how pigmented these are. I think it was very smart of Colourpop to do kind of a split down the middle, half very vibrant colorful shades and half very neutral bronzy gold type leaning shades. I can see a lot of people really liking these shadow sticks. I think they're easy. They don't take a lot of work, but again, I will, since Colourpop sent me these, I want to test them and try them. I definitely probably would have picked up a couple on my own at either Ulta or Target when I was placing an order. I really want to try the white as a base. I also think that peachy color, like kind of peach orange leaning color, looks beautiful, and that pale pink. I think those are super duper pretty. So we'll definitely test and try those out together. And they're only $8 each, which I also think is a really good price. Okay, UOMA Beauty has new double take skin perfecting blush duos. These duos look really, really beautiful, and the models that they have these on also, of course, look beautiful. I mean, they're models. That's kind of their job, yeah? But this says, it's a collection that celebrates human connection and all the joy it brings into our lives. Double the love, double the joy, double the pigment. It says, this product is designed to put a smile on your face. They have Muru Muru Butter, Emollient Esters, Zinc, and they say the formula is buildable and layers beautifully. $33 each. So these are all shimmery blushes. So it looks like one side is matte and one side is shimmer from what I can tell. I may be wrong about that, but that's what I'm getting when I look at the photos. Half shimmer, half matte blush. So I think these look really pretty. I like that they say that they are a buildable formula that layers. So you can wear them sheer or you can build them up for a more rich color. Definitely let me know what you think of this. These are available now, it says, at Ulta. So I will put a link to them down below. $33, I feel like that's in line for UOMA's price point. Definitely pricey, but I feel like that fits with the price point of the rest of the brand. I am passing on these for now, but if I'm in store and I see these at my local Ulta, I would definitely like to look at these, see like how much shimmer is in there. Are they super duper glowy? Are they not super duper? You know, like I would like to see these in person. Okay, Shine by SD is having another collaboration with MJone5018 and the makeup artist Lisa. I cannot pronounce her Instagram handle, so I will type out both of their names as they appear on Instagram down below in the description box. Definitely check out both creators. They're both very talented, post a lot of really cool swatch content, photos, things like that. But they are back with Duality 2.0 Dusk Till Dawn. Right now, all I have to share with y'all is the Dawn palette. So this says, I'm reading this post from MJone5018 Instagram account. It says, meet Dawn, the sister to dusk. It has pinks, golds, greens, and baby blues. That the creators worked on these palettes together. These look really beautiful. This is all I have to share right now, and all I can see is sparkle and soft, beautiful colors. I think Dawn is a great name for what I can see in this palette. Looks super duper beautiful. Really, really, really beautiful. I'm looking like, I keep thinking like, oh, this shade's calling to me. And then I'm like, no, the other one, no, the other one is. So these look beautiful. Congratulations to Shine by SD and to the creators. I think this is super cool. Juvia's Place has new blushed liquid blushes. These are available now at Juvia's Place. I'm not sure if these are coming to Ulta or not, but I hope so. These are blush liquid blushes in a buildable, radiant, pigmented, and blendable formulation, 12 universal and complementary hues. It says, this iconic liquid blush will accentuate your natural features in all the right places. This looks pretty. It looks like, okay, we have deep burgundies, deep earthy tones, bronze, peach, rose, red, fuchsia pink, candy pink, peachy pink, nude coral, soft peach, lots of different shades. When these come to Ulta, I'll probably purchase these, or I'll just order them from the Juvia's Place site. I have ordered from the Juvia's Place site lots of times. I always have a great experience. And I'm not sure what color I would pick, though. I really love pink blush. I just really do. So maybe the, like, more pinky shades. But I also think some of those more brown undertone blushes look really, really beautiful. If you're tired of all the pink blushes that you see and you want some more brown tones, this could definitely be for you because it looks like there are deep earthy tones in the shade Perky Poppy, and that says Lily Rich is a rich and deep bronzed warm earthy tone. So maybe these could be for you. I would definitely be curious about these. Let me know what you think. Okay, Givenchy Beauty has a new collection coming out. Now, we have limited edition products. The Rose Perfect Marble Lip Balm in 4 shades that have shea butter and hyaluronic acid. I really liked their lip gloss, lip cream that I bought. I have it like right here in some of my lip products. I'm like, I think it's right in here, but I love those, the ones that look swirly. I really liked it. It was very expensive, but I really liked it. I didn't regret spending the money. So I may have to pick up one of these just to test and try. There's also going to be a Skin Perfect Compact Cream that is a white and pink marble moisturizer and sunscreen in a portable case. I don't need that. There's an eye cream, a sunscreen stick, and a Skin Perfect Emulsion SPF. It says it's a sunscreen lotion with a slight pink hue. None of this I need. It says in Japan it's going to launch in June. I'm not sure when it's coming to the US. I'm guessing later than June. Either way, I'm going to keep my eye out for the lip balms because I do think those look really cute. But, you know, if they stay in Japan, they don't come to the US, I won't cry about it. It'll be fine, but I would like to pick one up. Morphe has a new collection. This is the Heart Seeker collection. Looks very warm and peachy summertime. There's going to be a brush set. So 5-piece brush set for $26. The palette is $22. So the palette to me looks very repetitive. The first two columns, like, those could have been 2 shades. They could have eliminated 4 of those shadows and just kept 2, I think. One of the mattes and one of the shimmers. I don't know. It looks so repetitive. Like I say, there are some times where I love big palettes. There are some times when I love more edited palettes. To me, knowing Morphe, I feel like this could have been edited down. It's definitely the Too Faced packaging, but it is what it is. I don't have any strong opinions on this one way or the other. I just feel like overall it's boring, and that's my judgment. All right, y'all, that is all we have to talk about today. If anything is announced, shown between the time that I film this and the time that it goes live, Sunday morning, my time, we can definitely talk about it next week. Thank you so much for those of y'all who tag me on new releases on Instagram. I really appreciate it. It helps me see what you want me to talk about. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I have lots of videos planned for you. I did film this eye look for my member tutorial for April, so I will link to the membership down below. No worries, if you're not a member, none of my content here on YouTube changes. The membership is just something extra, and I will link the products that I have on down below. I am wearing some of my Glam Light palettes, a little Bella Beauté bar. I'm wearing this one from Guerlain, still testing, still reviewing. I have to try it a few more times before I can tell y'all my final thoughts, but just know I wore this for 13 hours yesterday in the rain. Everything, my oily skin, it still looked beautiful. I can't stop wearing it. I'm wearing it today, but I need to test it a little more, and then I'll come back and I'll review it fully for y'all. But everything will be in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having an amazing day. I'll have new videos for you tomorrow. Make sure to subscribe, and yeah, I'll see you later. Bye.